Río corriente. Father, we ask that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, you're the Father of glory. We ask that you would give unto us your spirit of wisdom, your revelation. We ask for the knowledge of you. We ask for the eyes of our understanding to be opened, to be enlightened, so that we would know what is the hope of your calling, what is the riches of your glory, what is our inheritance as your saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of your power toward us who believe. Oh, Father God. We are far above all principalities and powers and might and dominion and every name that is named. We are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Father God, when Jesus rose up out of that grave, when he rose up out of hell, he took his heavenly place and he took us with him. But first he had to take his blood to that mercy seat and put every drop of his blood on the mercy seat. That covers everything for us in Jesus' name. Do you agree?
Amen.
We have an agreement. So why don't you be seated? I want to start something a little bit here. How many of you feel that you, don't raise your hand, that you hear the voice of God, that you've heard or hear from God? Just ponder that in your heart, okay? I do every time. Are you bragging, Pastor Jan? I'm bragging on him. Because we can. Because he said, my sheep hear my voice. Is that John 10:34? My sheep hear my voice. Mm-hmm. The voice of a stranger I'll not listen to. Since we have been learning about the word and about what we say, all right? We know without a shadow of a doubt that we can watch our mouth and we can put our hand over our mouth like it says in Psalms. Why? Because we don't want cursing to come out of our mouth. And I was telling him in the prayer room here a little bit, when I say to you, I say, I am healed. And I say, Dee Dee, you're healed. I just prayed over you. You're healed. And Dee Dee says, well, I don't think so, Pastor Jan. She just cursed. Do you realize she just swore, cursed? Who did she do it to? She did it to God because she said to God, I don't believe what you said. Isn't that wonderful that he's got the blood of Jesus that covers us until we come to the age of understanding? And a mature person is one that takes the word of God and puts it first place and believes it, even though they don't understand it sometime. And how many times didn't I tell you, you get the word, you don't understand it, put it on a shelf. I've still got stuff from the word. Oh my, a lot of stuff, I ain't kidding you, that I read it, but I put it on the shelf until the Lord will bring it to me, and I'll go, I got to go back to that scripture, and he'll bring it alive. Now, how are some of the ways? We'll just give a couple, two, three ways that you hear the voice of the Lord. How do you hear the voice of the Lord? One of them is peace. When you have peace for a situation, that's hearing the voice. Do you realize it? You've got five senses, and you hear through all of the five senses. Okay, what is another way that you hear the voice of the Lord? You through what?
The word of God.
Through the word of God. You open this up, and when you read that, and you read it out loud, you're hearing the voice of God. That's the voice of God. One other that's really, really important. Let's say you need counsel, but you want to go to somebody who's not on your same level, that you can go and that you know has discernment, you know prays in the Holy Spirit, and that the Holy Spirit speaks through them because they listen. So when you go for counseling, that counseling will go through that person that's mature. And the Holy Spirit will say words through that counselor, and sometimes you go, I don't know if I can go along with that. Well, a lot of times it's far out. We understand that? So through counseling, through godly counseling, through feelings, really, the feeling of peace, the Word of God. That's just three of them for right now, okay? There's other ways that you hear from God, because we can go into, and I used to feel that all the time, God, why don't you listen to me? But did you ever read a scripture, you're reading and all of a sudden it jumps out at you, one of the scriptures? That's big time hearing. You just got revelation. Do you see what I'm saying? So we can get that. That's why we want to stay familiar with this Word of God. What do I mean by that? We want to read it and say, listen, if you said, 1 Peter 2:24, God says, by my stripes, you're healed. Is that not what it says? Because you have been healed. And if he says, I'll supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory, not to mine, is that hearing from God? How about for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. But too many times do we believe in him in just those three areas? Do we believe him? That's what you got to work on believing. So how do you work on that? You start saying, he leads and guides me into all truth. I always know what to say. I always know what to do. I'm always in the right place at the right time. What you're doing is you're speaking, and the more you speak it, all of a sudden it's going to go, fall on you. And you're going to know what to do. You're going to get in a situation that might look like a tight situation. You're going to know exactly what to do. Because of discerning, because the word in it may be scripture you didn't even learn. All of a sudden, it's going to pop out at you. But you're like, oh, that makes sense. And one day you'll see that word in the Lord. I mean, that word that the Lord gave you in this word. And you didn't even understand it. That's why also praying in tongues. Why would you pray in tongues? Because you're releasing God's word into your spirit man so that when you have need of it, it'll come out here. By saying, I always know what to do, I always know what to say, I'm always in the right place at the right time, I have whatever I ask for. Listen, if you go for something, you're going for a sale, you got to give that after a while, it just hit me. Or do you want to give that now? The wallet. Okay, Dee Dee, come on and do that. He just brought that up. Come on up, be obedient. No, be obedient to him. Don't you mess with God. Listen, you got to brag on God. She's not bragging on Dee Dee. She's got to brag on God. Why do you brag on God? Because look at what he's done. Go ahead, brag on him.
My nephew Reese is 15. We went to the fair, and he had his wallet in his pocket. After the fair, he went and helped a friend of his put bark landscaping in a big yard. But anyways, when we got to the house, he said he'd lost his wallet. He had $47 in it. He lost his wallet. And so we went out to Peyton's car where he had ridden first, and we looked through everything, and then I said, okay, let's stop. Now let's pray that, you know, God has got to bring that wallet to us. He's got to bring it across our path with your money in it. Now in the meantime, my sister is next to me. She's praying to a saint. But Reese looked at me and said, amen, Aunt Dee Dee. I said, Reese, we have an agreement. It has to come to pass. Well, then I called my sister Kim one day, and I said, did Reese find his wallet? She asked Reese, and she said, no, Reese didn't find his wallet yet. I said, well, we prayed. It has to come to pass. And she said, we'll see.
Did you get that? What does we see tell you?
I don't believe.
It's not going to happen. Go ahead.
So yesterday, I'm babysitting, and Reese and his friend Hayden are there, and all of a sudden, I hear the word wallet. And I turned, and I looked at Reese, and I said, did you find your wallet? He goes, yes, Hayden found it in his yard at his house. And I said, see, we prayed. And we said, God had to bring it across our path.
Absolutely.
With your money in it. Mm-hmm. And did that not happen, Reese? Yes, it did, Aunt Dee Dee.
Is that good? See, what she did was she did not speak, she did not curse. See, whenever you're speaking against God's word, you have to get an understanding that you're cursing. Right? Choose this day whom you're going to serve, life or death, right? So now, when he agreed with you, you had an agreement, the devil could not hold back that wallet. And there's a big lawn. This was a big lawn. It was a huge lawn. To find the wallet, come on, you guys. God is on the move. So when you speak, he does the work. God had to go get that. So if there's something that you prayed for and you didn't get, I don't care what it looks like. I don't care if it feels like you've lost it and you're not going to ever get it. I don't care if it's a possession of yours, a kid of yours, a job, whatever. Don't give up. Keep on going after it. Take the.
Going through that, and while you're waiting, you know what you're. What I am saying, God. Now she was praying to that saint, and we know you're not to be praying to saints. Now, God, you got to get in here because I want them to see that you are exactly what I said you were. And I kept praying that. I know, God, you are finding that wall and you're bringing it across their path. I kept saying every time that doubt would come into my mind because I wanted God to show up. And show out to those people. I know. Yeah.
So when she got an agreement with Reese, it was already finished. Amen. The only thing she had to do is because the devil's going to say, you can't get that back. You can't have that. You can't do that. You go, you shouldn't say that to me because you know I got it. I already have what I asked for. See, that's why too many people let go of what they asked for. They said, well, that didn't work. What you just did was you just, can I say it this way again? You cursed God. You swore at God. What do I mean by that? What you did was you say, God, I don't believe that two or more agree and it shall come to pass. Do you see? God says when we speak opposite of his word, it's evil. Is cursing, swearing evil? Yeah, but who are we getting angry with? Are we getting angry with that person? Are we cursing that person? Or are we cursing God? We're cursing God because it's God's word that we should put first place. And he said, just believe me, no matter how far out it seems, just believe me. Does that make sense? That's heavy, I know, but it's true. So that's why we have to guard our mouth. So let me ask you, are you guarding your heart and watching over your mouth? Are you really doing that, every word that comes out of your mouth? You know, we're getting, how many of you, since we've been learning this here, you've been around some people, not from the church, of course, or a family member or something, and you hear them talk and all of a sudden it's like your ears hurt. I mean, it's like down inside there's such a bad feeling you want to up chucking away. Do you know what I'm talking about? All of a sudden, it's like this here. Ooh, I don't want to hear that. Because you become that sponge that you have downloaded the Word of God. And so when the enemy comes along to poke you, the Word of God is going to come out. Just like that sponge is full of water. Remember Keith Moore was saying? The minute the devil pokes you that something isn't going to happen, you're so full of the Word that you say, oh no, I have an agreement. I have an agreement for that wallet. I've got an agreement. It's got to happen. So have your sponge so full of water that the minute somebody touches it, you sponge, meaning your spirit man, whoosh, the word will come out. And to constantly fill that up. I think that's such a wonderful example. So let's dig in and understand a little bit better what Keith Moore was talking about, what some of the other speakers that we had, like Bill Winston, and what they were talking about, okay? Why? Because we don't want to believe, we only want to believe God. In John 10, John says to us in John 10, he said, I do not listen to anybody else's voice but to the Good Shepherd, Jesus Christ. I'll only listen to him when his comes to my ears. But if it's evil, I will not take it in. Because if you take it in, you know how the enemy can get you rolling the wrong direction? Did you ever do that? Yeah. You get going along. You've already had that when you're driving along. Father God, save whoever's going on, and mercy over the person if it's speeding or so. Just take care of it in Jesus' name. But what is lo corriete, arrio corriete, arrio corriete? You want me to go there? No, stick with this here. Okay. All right. The enemy is always going to come after you and steal, kill, and destroy. Okay, we'll pick up what we just went off of in a minute. So is that true? Yes. Is he always trying to steal the word of God? Who is he trying to, who is the enemy trying to get you offended with, offended over? God. We think we get offended over people because people come up against us. Is that true? Yes. No. The enemy is really getting you offended with God. If you join in on getting angry. Now, you look at people, for instance, that are preaching the Word of God and the truth of the Word of God. Look at it, some countries, what are they doing? They're burning them at the stake. They're killing them. What did they do with Paul? What did they do with the disciples? Because the truth was being spoken and people were set free. What are they doing to our president? I mean, because God has sent this man for such a time as this, because you look back at his mother, Donald Trump's mother, Mary, and how she was on this island and how revival was and just a part of that, and that's sown into that boy, and look what's happened. I had somebody not too long ago, I heard him on a radio station. I don't know what station it was, even I was riding in the car and I was trying, but it was a Christian one. I don't know if it was 90.1 or something. And this Christian guy said, and he was a speaker for something, he said, I don't know if President Donald Trump is even saved. And I was like, oh, I can't believe he said, and he's a Christian, and he's a Christian speaker. That's all he has to do is ask God. That's all he has to do is ask God. Show me. And he will. I heard President Donald Trump, this was on Facebook. Yeah, and he was giving his testimony. I mean, was it a good testimony? How God brought him into this. And this is God that did this and so on. It's just phenomenal. But we've got to listen to the voice of the Good Shepherd. So going a little bit back to that. But remember, what goes into your heart is going to come out through your mouth. So if you're hanging around people that are against the Word of God, or they say to you, well, healing isn't for everybody, you know. Do you have to defend that? No. No, God's got to defend that. Now, if you're there and they start saying, well, isn't that true? I would go, absolutely not. Well, let me tell you and give you a testimony about what I just went through. Let me give you a testimony about you, about you, about you, about you. Let me give you a testimony. What a way to witness to people. Can they really bark at that? You heard Max up here last Sunday with his testimony. That's his testimony. Nobody can give his testimony. Right? Do you think God is real? To take him all the way through that garbage? Do you think that's real? Oh. So, what does Christianity, Christian, mean? It means confession, great confessions. Who was Christ? Who was Christ? The anointed one, huh? Jesus Christ. So who is that to us? That's the great confession. We confess Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Whenever we ask for something, whenever we pray or two or more come together, how do we seal it? We seal it with, in Jesus' name. That's a confession. That's a great confession. So being a doer of the word means you read that word, right? You read, but then you speak it. You might have to read it and read it and read it to get yourself built up. Hey, I believe that. This is what's going to happen. I heard that. This is what's going to happen. You're going to read scripture and you're going to say, that just popped out at me. I'm going to take that. And it might go 2-3 weeks. And all of a sudden, whatever you took, there it is. And you'll go, how did that happen? Ask God. He'll take you back when that first entered in. He'll do it. He'll do it. All right? So when you speak, what are you doing? When you speak something, like if I say, for me and my house we shall serve the Lord, I just released my faith by speaking it. I don't care how bad the situation is. I don't care, I don't care, I don't care. You speak it. How could I speak it about my brother Dwayne? How could I speak it and then he comes to know Jesus and I get to lead him? And even his wife. How was that? Do you understand what I'm saying? I got to lead my mama, my daddy. How many years ago did I do that? Long time ago. But is he born again? Yes. Is he in heaven today? Yes. You know, just because things don't happen right away, you don't get undone, but things are going to happen faster and faster and faster and faster and faster. Because the more that you speak to yourself in songs and hymns and spiritual, you're going to say, whoa. Well, did you ever have something come up against you and it really doesn't feel good? You just don't like it and you would rather just lay down and let it run you over and get it over with? Remember that song, Going Through Hell? How does that song go? Going through hell? Give me some. Keep on moving. Don't slow down. If you're scared, don't show it. You might get out before the devil even knows your name. That's the stuff we've got to take. See, that's the things that I have stored up in here. Do you understand that? Store up those songs. Store up those. Because that's the truth. Okay? He can't even stop you because when you pray in the Spirit, he can't understand when you're praying in the Spirit. But you know what? You just continue to praise God. Your praise will lift that husband, that wife up, that parent, that child, whatever. Just trust the word. When you take Hebrews and you say, his word is sharper than any two-edged sword. So you mean when I see the word and I speak the word, that is sharper than any two-edged sword? When they talked about a two-edged sword, it was sharp on both sides that when Samson or David went, they could take off heads here and go right back there and take them. This was a big sword. This was big. Just take them off here and take them off here. They could go through that crowd and kill thousands of people, men. That's what your tongue does to the devil. Do you understand that? Your tongue is sharper than any two-edged sword, and it's cutting to the joints and the marrow. That means it's getting into the person that you're praying for that you don't even know how to pray. The only thing you have to do is keep your nasty little hands out of it. Don't we? Didi and I were talking about that a while ago. I always want to fix it. I always want to get my hands in there. And it's like... I'm still going to laugh when I'm holding Keisha back when the little gunner was going up on that what do you call that, blow-up thing? The bouncy house at our house. And I'm pulling her. Oh, no, I'm pulling you back. I'm pulling her back away. You know, sometimes, just I got to get this picture in you. I got to get it in me, too. There's times when we got to just stop. And hopefully God is taking us and pulling us away that we can't get loose to go fix the situation. We were talking about that not too long ago in the testimonies on a Thursday morning. You know, when you speak the word of God, the word is sharper than any two-edged sword. Not you, not your tongue, but the words that you just released will go out there and take the enemy out that's coming against you, against your family, against your finances, against your prosperity. It will cut to the bone and go right into the bone. So there isn't anything hidden. There isn't anything that once you prayed that God will not bring to pass. Get way out on a limb. Get way out. Get out there. So how do you become a doer of the word? You find the scripture, and then you speak. You can hear the word, but if you don't speak it, then you're not a doer. But once you speak it, make sure you speak it and speak it and speak it. But it's like Joyce Meyer said that time, she was hanging onto the chair, like, right? Why was she doing that? Why was she doing it? Because she wanted to go and make something happen. Right? So now just think, if we allow the Holy Spirit to help us to shut up and get our hands off the situation. You could have went out and looked for that wallet every day for Reese. Wouldn't have did you diddly squat. No. No. One time, Keisha lost her phone out on our lawn. It was on silence. She walked around. What happened? She heard it vibrate.
I don't think I found it
until
the next day.
Yeah, but you found it.
Yeah, I did find
it. It was the next day.
Yeah, because I was looking for it that night, and we agreed that it was going
to
be found.
Yeah, that just came to my mind. But always remember, do we give up too fast, guys? Do we set ourselves in agreement with somebody, and do we give it up? Do we give up? But the minute you give up, and then you start doing it yourself, and you're trying to make it happen, and how do you hear from God? When you have peace. If you don't have peace, and you're going forth and doing something, you're on the wrong bus. You know? You want to go to California, and you're on the bus to Florida. It's the wrong way. So how do we get on the right bus? You know, take it. Remember when they said that in Psalms that my mouth is my own? And it is. It is. But what God is saying us in the Psalms is put a hand over your mouth. Don't, what's, if foul stuff got in here, don't let it come out here. Don't let it come out here. Because it will put us in bondage, but it will hold back and destroy what we really prayed for. And there are so many miracles out there, but what are we doing with them? We're not trusting God. Hey, listen, that's hard to do. Until you get some victory, it's like you get a taste of that blood. We had that big Barnaby, and remember we gave him to Jack and Marion and their son Buck, and what happened was he got chasing deer. Remember that? And once he did that, he was no good anymore. Because he was chasing deer. Isn't that chasing deer? He was no good anymore. They don't want him chasing down deer. They're going to get in trouble where they are. So when at that time. So if we can just take the word, and the enemy is going to torment and torment and torment you. I don't care what situation is. If you just stand, and what does he do? Once you've done all, what do? Stand. And then just see that sponge, see the word of God, that you're so full of it that he hits and you just hit him right back with the word. The water of the word, right back at him. The water of the word just comes right back. For me and my house we shall serve the Lord. My God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. Do you understand? By the stripes of Jesus, I was healed. My children are obedient. My grandchildren are obedient. I'm obedient. I've got the best job in the world. You want another job? Go for it. Go for it. But don't give up. The devil will fight you when it's something you want. Right? Yeah. So now, we remember Keith Moore was saying this, and this is so true. Can your tongue control your whole body? If you speak only the word of God. Do you ever get scared of something and it's late at night and you really couldn't speak even, you were so scared and you were all alone? Did you ever happen to you? You just freeze, don't you? That's what the devil wants you to do. He wants you to freeze and stand still, and he'll come and steal you blind. But you're like, uh-uh. So Jesus said what he did is he only spoke the word of God. Only what his Father told him to speak. He did not even speak on his own. That's pretty powerful, because remember, he came as a man. He did not come as the Son of God. He came as a flesh and blood human being. We know, we understand that, don't we? Did he watch every word that came out of his mouth? Did he rebuke the enemy? Yeah. And I had this person. Oh, it made me laugh in a way. They were instant messenger. Oh, we got to walk in love and talk about some of the stuff that's going on. Oh, we got to walk in love. And I thought, you are nothing but dangerous. And I put a scripture out, we walk in love, just like Jesus when he came up against the devil. Never instant message me back. The word speaks for itself. Did Jesus get feisty? He was no, and take a back seat to anything. Why was they going to kill him? Bad, bad. So Jesus only spoke what the Father told him to speak. Was it written in the old? Absolutely. Was he a rabbi? Did he know what it said? Absolutely. Did all the rabbis know that? Absolutely. How come so many of them didn't listen? How about the Pharisees and the Sadducees? Why didn't they listen? Because they were into self and they were into other gods, which is money and walking around and just, you know, walking around the temple. Like, look at us here. Look at here. They were all puffed up. They got so mad, Jesus couldn't even hang with them anymore. But did he win? Absolutely. Matthew 21:21, this says, Jesus answered and said unto them, Verily I say unto you, now that's, he's talking to us, if you have faith and doubt not, you shall not only do this, which is done to the fig tree, but also if you shall say unto this mountain, Be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, it shall be done. Can we believe that? See, that's why we got to take those scriptures and you memorize them. I went in and got another verse, and I believe this was, which one did I get here? I thought, A New Century. Get the different ones that speak to you. So no matter how hard the situation, and you're hanging on for dear life, all right, and the devil just keeps on slapping you around, don't let go of that promise. Take that promise to the bank. It is sharper than any two-edged sword, and that word will not come back to you void, but it will accomplish what you sent it out to do. That's all you have to do is guard your heart. How do you guard your heart? By not letting it come out here. Because you'll want to give in. Come on, don't tell me we all don't get upset and like, oh God, I've just had enough of this. Come on. I do. So now, so he only did what the Father told him to do. Jesus tells us. Now, in Luke 6:31, this is the Message Bible. Here is a simple rule of thumb for behavior. Ask yourself what you want people to do for you. Then grab the initiative and do it for them. Isn't that what Jesus did? Absolutely. If you only love the lovable, do you expect a pat on the back? Run-of-the-mill sinners do that. If you only help those who help you, do you expect a medal? Garden variety sinners do that. Like a flower garden, you know, garden. If you only give for what you hope to get out of it, do you think that's charity, love? The stingiest of pawnbrokers do that. When you get somebody, and this just rang, well, wow. God says, I want you to go over and witness. God told you to spend time with that woman at Sturgis. And she did it, and you had a ball. Didn't look at first, you know. But when you step out and do something. Do you understand that? The other day, the Lord said, I want you to give somebody this amount of money. Absolutely. Get out of my way, everybody. Somebody had given me a nice little handshake, and I just turned around and gave it. Do you know how good it felt? So now, God says, I want people to walk in love, go and witness to people. Just think there again. Hear people come along and they say, well, I don't believe in that word. This is Christians, even non-Christians. I don't believe in that word. I don't think that can really happen. Oh, you talk about healing. I don't really believe that. Well, let me tell you about my testimony, right, Dixie? And somebody got healed because of my testimony. I'm bragging on God. I'm bragging on God. See, you can use each other's testimonies and go and give it to people. That's what that's about. That's what that's about. Do you understand that? God wants us to give testimony of what he did. I gave my testimony today and I put it on Facebook. And there were so many wonderful hits. I was like, wow, God. But what did I do? I told them, ask Jesus Christ into your heart. It's the best thing that I ever did. And be a doer of the word. Don't just look at the word and read it, but speak it. That's being a doer of it. That was pretty simple, right? Is somebody going to be touched? Now, when God, you know, when I was dragging my feet and God said to me today, you put that on there. Put that on. I told you to put it. Yes, sir. And I had peace after that because I was just, oh, I don't have time. Did you forget that? Oh, so I'm like, I'm not a procrastinator. Because you miss too many blessings. I missed too much. So when God said that, and I couldn't believe it, I turned around. It wasn't even a minute gone by. And it was like 8 hits, 1, 2, 10. I was like, how it helped. Thank you for that, Pastor Jen. You see, people are looking for hope. You have got something that they need. And it may not be on Facebook. It may be just out there in a grocery store that somebody stops and talks to you. It might be somebody here that you just look at them and you put your arms around them. You know, give them your testimony. Give them Max's testimony. Give them each other's testimony, the wallet testimony and so on. Give those things. That's what God did with the testimonies from this word. He gave them out. He gave them out. Because God's bragging on us, isn't he? He holds us up as a trophy. He's so proud of us. We're not bragging on ourselves because I know I can't do that. I can't get me healed, but I know who does. I know what his word does. There isn't anything impossible for my God. There isn't one husband or one wife or one child or one grandchild that will not get saved if you put the word of God on those scriptures for me in my house, we shall serve the Lord, and God guarantees you they're going to get saved. But keep your nasty little hands off because you might mess it up. You understand? Yeah. John 14:10, the Message Bible. You've been with me all this time, Philip, and you still don't understand. To see me is to see the Father. This is Jesus. So how can you ask, where is the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you aren't mere words. I don't just make them up on my own. The Father who resides in me crafts each word into a divine act. Doesn't that speak volumes? So when I speak his word, that's what's going to get this done. Every one of you have something. I can hear it. I can hear the different things you want. I can hear it. I can't understand, but I can understand. But there's certain things that you guys have prayed for and you've given up on. And God said, don't you dare give up. Don't you dare give up. Anything that you've had, don't you dare give up. You get back on there and you confess it and you stay on it and don't you dare let go. I don't care if you have to tie yourself up and gag your mouth. Do it. Well, he just said that. Thank you, Lord. John 14:10, New Century Version. Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words I say to you don't come from me. This is Jesus. But the Father lives in me and does his own work. Wait a minute. So the one who lives in us is the one that's doing the work, just like he did with Jesus? So Jesus was an example and he came as a man, flesh, bone, blood. Then his blood was all drained out of him. Then he took that before the mercy seat. Then he walked through the walls and visited with the boys and stayed for 40 days. He walked as a man and he's sitting in heaven as a man. He is not sitting in the heaven as God. He's sitting as a man. He's representing us and we're seated in him. And now again, who is he? God is a judge. Who's the advocator? Jesus. Do we have to give him something to work with? Do we have to plead our case to Jesus? What's your case? What do you want? What's not going the way you want it to go? Plead it. Take it. Give it to him, just like David did. What is it? Speak it. Okay, I'm going to get alone. We're going to do some work tonight, God. I want this, and that's just the way it's going to be, because that's just the way I want it. Does he say, what are we supposed to become? Are we supposed to be like a lion, go after it? Are we more than conquerors through Jesus Christ? Does a lion conquer everything just by the roar in the jungle? Oh, yes. That when they hear, other animals hear that, even though he's smaller than some animals, the whole jungle stops. The roar of Jesus Christ is roaring for us. Satan, you shouldn't have touched these people. You're going to the woodshed. And everything that you've asked, if you hang on to it, and you take and you tape up your mouth if you have to, tie yourself up in a closet if you have to, it will come to pass. It will come to pass. He said it. So, like it said in, remember that was in Psalms 12:4? Who does this mouth belong to? It belongs to you. You can do with it whatever you want. You have free will. I say, Father, I give you my mouth. I give you lips. I give you my vocal cord. He said, you can do that all day long, but if you go saying, well, Debbie, I just don't feel good. I prayed, but, I don't think it worked. What did I just do? I ruined the whole prayer. You know what that's called? You know what God calls that? Murmuring. He says, you're grumbling. Stop grumbling. Well, how am I grumbling? You're grumbling against the word of God, and you're saying it's not true. But is God's word true? Is it? Is it ever going to change? Is it the same yesterday, today, and forever? Absolutely. Who do we think you are? So, in Romans 4:12, what does Hebrews 4:12? The word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. Please don't forget that. And when you speak that word of God, you may not really be settled on it all the way. But the more you speak it and you say, wait a minute, I'm going to go over those scriptures that God gave Pastor Jan, and I'm going to get this in me. I'm fired up. I'm fired up, and I know I can have this. And then you fire up and you speak it, and you walk out the door and smash, somebody comes and runs into your car, or somebody calls you a bad name, or you call up and you say, they just smashed up the car. Just, you know what I mean? Your kid's in jail. Well, that's not that, but you know what I'm saying? You go. What is the devil doing? How soon does he come to steal, kill, and destroy? Cast all your care on him because he cares for you, right? Be sober, be vigilant, because the devil, he comes around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. God said, expect that. That's why you want to have that sponge inside of you. You want your spirit so filled up with the water of the word. You come out and the devil touches you. You just throw the word right at him. Just, Kenneth Hagin said, if you believe and you speak and you believe and you have faith, you won't wait long. You won't wait long. So, remember they were talking about a gun. Your tongue is what? An ever-ready writer. Your tongue is supposed to speak psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. It's supposed to make a melody unto the Lord. That's what he was saying, David was saying. So we're supposed to sing unto the Lord. When Joshua sent out the worship team and blah, blah, around the walls of Jericho, and then remember when they were going to go to battle? Debbie, when we go into battle and there's going to be guns and stuff flowing, I want you guys to go first. In fact, I'll be there to lead you. I won't miss a chance if I could get out there right away. Because you know we win. Because when you praise and worship, God says, I will set up a standard against the devil. And he says, I will come in like a flood, just like they did it, like I did in Egypt, and I'll wipe every one of them out. The wheels were still spinning and they were drowning one after another. We got it. We've got it. We've got it. got it. But you got to speak what you want. Speak what you want. I got to tell you this. Last few years, I didn't just thought about it now. We stayed at a place in Florida. I didn't like it. I didn't like it. This is the one place I said to Pastor Kenny, no, I don't want to stay at those places. He goes, me neither. Well, guess what? Here he finds out and gets us the place we want to go. How did that happen? Oops. We agreed. How you did that still, I don't know. You see, guys, we can't give up. You can't give up. When you speak something, hang on to it. Don't let go. And put your flesh aside. And listen, if you have a hard time, call somebody up and get some counsel. Say, help me. I just feel like giving in. Help me. I'll tie you up and put you in a closet. We'll get a big vault in the church here and tie you up there and put a feeding tube in there. And you know what I mean? God is so good. Do you think so? He's good. Let's take communion. Let's take an offering. Where did I put that? Oh my, where did I put it? Here? Oh, thank you, Jesus. That's why you want to give yourself. You want to give yourself because he's saying, what can I give to you? You know that thing you've been wishing for, hoping for, praying for a long time? Yep. Well, just go ahead. What is it worth to you? Oh, it's worth $5, but I want $1 million back. If that's all I had is the $5, that would be good. According to my faith. You know it. So let's stand up. Then we're going to have some testimonies. I know you got testimonies. This is our opportunity. Whenever you give, fill up that sponge. That I have the promises of God. Somebody told me that the other day too, telling her husband, hey, we have been tithing and offering. This has got to come to pass. This has got to happen for us good. And it did. Did you get it? This is serious stuff. So let's do it right now. You come up, you put that in there, whether it be tithe or offering or whatever. Let's come up and let's do that right now. And when you give it now, you stand on the word. You stand on the word. You stand on the word, you guys. You stand on the word. Say, it comes to pass. I pay my tithe and I give offering. It's got to come to pass. It's got to come to pass. It's got to come to pass. Sharper than a two-edged sword. It's got to come to pass. What's got to come to pass? Whatever you are standing for. You know that? You'll get according to your faith. Okay? I want big time stuff. I don't want little stuff. Amen. Amen. I like to hear that. I like to hear that. I like to hear that. In Jesus' name. Now, as we're going to take communion, God told us, he said, I want you to take the bread because that is my body and I want you to lift it up and I want you to break it because I'm the bread of life. He said, the bread of life, He said, the bread of life, who is Jesus Christ, has set the whole thing up for us. And what did he take? What did he take? Hey, this was long before he got to the cross. He was being beaten and whipped. Look at that. What a mess, huh? So we look at him on the cross. And we just made a fair exchange. Our poverty for his prosperity. Say, my poverty, for his prosperity. For his prosperity. Oh, for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. By the stripes of Jesus, every stripe on his back is for whatever is going on in my body right now. I am healed.
I am healed.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
For me and my house,
we shall serve the Lord.
I have peace.
I have joy.
In the name of Jesus, let's eat. Thank you, Father. Now, We're going to take this. This symbolizes that blood that ran down. That blood ran down onto the ground, but not one itty-bitty little spot of blood was left. Jesus came out of hell. He picked it back up and went up to heaven and put it on the mercy seat just for us. Why? Because he made us the righteousness of God, so he made you sinless. Oh, I'm just an old sinner saved by grace. No, you're not. That's swearing. No, I'm God's perfect child. Well, you just messed up, you know. I saw you speeding and guilty. I saw you kill that. Nope, not guilty. That's what he did for us. Come on, you guys, get with the program, right? In the name of Jesus, let's drink. My God is an awesome God. Thank you, Miss Lori. He is so awesome. He's so good to me. Is he good to you? Let's do this here. Let's have some testimonies. We gave some already. But who has a testimony? You may be seated. Who's got a testimony? Pastor Kenny's got the...
So mine is on just in general, you know, God says we can have prosperity in our relationships. So again, which one am I going to give? One or that one? Okay, got it. So in my mind, what Keith Moore had been talking about, certain times you'll have thoughts go through your mind at night at 2 a.m. in the morning, and you have to come up against those thoughts that even will come, thank you, that will even come in your mind at 2 a.m. in the morning. Well, I had this thought last week, and it was 2 a.m. in the morning, and I was I was in bed, and I was rolling to the other side, and this torment thought came through my mind as I was rolling to the other side. And it wanted to bring me down. It wanted to, it was trying to steal, like the devil was trying to steal my joy right when I turned over, because I thought something about a situation with one of the people that, my parents, one of the things that they were going through, and I thought about that situation, and it bothered me right then, instantly. And it was like, I got up out of bed, and it was, I had to start to kind of, it was a fight to get that thought out of my mind. I mean, it was trying to really torment me. And it was like, the first thing I thought of was what you said to do, was start to turn on praise and worship music. So I turned on the music, 2 a.m, I'm listening to some of the music that you had, because I have it on my playlist for YouTube, some of the music that you sing up here, the Resurrected King, and Jesus is, I can't even think of all of them. But anyway, I have them on my playlist in YouTube. So I start playing this music, and I start praying in the Spirit. And I'm praying in the Spirit for like 10 minutes or so. And it kind of, then all of a sudden, it went away.
Amen. Amen.
And I was like, thank you, Lord. I thank you. I knew what to do at 2 a.m. in the morning. Because certain times you just have thoughts come through your mind.
Yes.
And
yes.
What it wanted to do was change my whole night, my whole next day. And I was like, thank you, Lord, for showing me exactly how to deal with that thought. Because in the past, I think I would just kind of let it like, oh, it's just a thought. So I had to just kind of deal with it. I wouldn't necessarily give it over to the Lord, but I didn't receive it, but I didn't attack it. And I needed to attack it at that moment. So my other testimony is just on, again, what Marcus was teaching the men on, the crazy cycle. I noticed it was coming into our house. That crazy cycle wanted to go into the house. And at the moment that it would happen, me and Steve were perceiving different ways of certain things I had talked about prior. We were perceiving it differently, what I thought about it, what he thought about it. Mm-hmm. And he was telling me how he thought about it, and I was telling him how I thought about it. But it was just, we were telling each other what we thought about it. So that night, it was like, Lord, I give this over to you. And I wrote down exactly how I was feeling. Now, I didn't say, oh, Mark, you're over there. Hi. And I was just telling him, and I wrote down how I was feeling about the situation and what I wanted to tell him the next day when he got up in the morning. So I wrote it down, though. And when I wrote it down, I'm like, I felt so good because I could go to sleep and leave it at that. I was like, okay, I'm going to leave it at that this tonight. We most definitely don't need to talk about it anymore tonight. Mm-hmm. When I got up the next morning, I didn't say anything, but I did pray. I prayed to God, like, I give this over to you, and I thank you for taking it. And got up the next morning. We started in devotional, and all that, it didn't go away, but we were able to talk about certain things. Wow. And what he was perceiving and what he was getting out of it, I would have never thought to even address or bring up, or how I would approach the solution to the problem. And I'm like, Lord, help me. Thank you for showing us and bringing us together. Yes. Because the solution I thought wasn't even where he was even perceiving or wanted to go.
Oh.
So I was like, thank you. I thank you, Lord. It was just a blessing, because certain times you think you're what you're going to say, and the God in you is going to be the thing that changes it. But other things needed to come out, needed to be talked about, that was different. And we had a good day, and it went well, and it quickly changed.
You know, the neat thing about it, this, did you ever want to just get somebody and you say, Lord, change my heart, I don't want this? Remember Joyce Meyer said that, change my heart, and all of a sudden he'll start changing. You know what the Lord just said to me? I'm supposed to pray over people. Anybody, would you put Resurrected King on, please? I'm supposed to pray over people. I'm supposed to anoint you and pray over you. And I'm going to be obedient. So if you need prayer, you're just going to get anointed and let the Holy Spirit, I don't know what it is, don't care, that's not my business, that's his business. So anybody who would like prayer, come on up. Come on up. If your prayer has not been answered and you want it answered, we're going to give you a jump start.
Amen.
Are you willing? Are you willing? Who can get back here? Who can get back here just in case? Yep. Father, we thank you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Receive it in Jesus' name. Whatever you want, it's yours, he said. Take it by faith. Do you take it by faith?
I do.
Amen.
Amen.
Do you want to be next?
Well, sure, but Miss Mary was next.
We'll get Miss Mary. Whatever you've been praying for, God said it's yours. Because the obedience of coming up and receiving it, that's the obedience, by coming up. Because sometimes we don't want to come up because we don't want people to see us. Mm-hmm. No, the obedience is when you come up, you're going to get what you ask for. In the name of Jesus, you receive that?
Yes.
Amen. The fight is over. In Jesus' name. It's done. Continue to speak the word of God. Amen. Oh, thank you. Whatever, the fight is over. The fight is over. The fight is over. You receive it? You've been wanting something for a long time. And it is finished.
That once was crowned with thorns.
Oh, he's
is
so
crowned
cool.
With glory.
Just suck it in
now.
Every inch of it. Take it by faith. It belongs
Savior
to you.
Now
in
to
Jesus' name.
Now at his feet.
Anybody else? Come on up. Turn it up a little bit. I like it loud. You've been standing for something for a long time, too. It's time in Jesus' name.
Now robed in majesty, the radiance of perfect love.
Take it. Just take it, Pat. Let him just take over. It's time. It's time, and I know what it is. It's your husband. It's time. It's time. You've just received it. It's yours. It's yours. There's stuff going on, but not anymore. You are free in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And your children are free as well. In Jesus' name.
To him who is our peace, his final breath upon the cross.
It's yours.
Is now alive.
It's done. It's done.
In your name is victory.
I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. You're going to close this, because this is what gets you in trouble, God just said. You're going to close that, and you're going to keep it closed. But for speaking the word. And it is done. You were obedient. You came up and received it. It is done.
He
wants you to rest on the
show. Alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit, oh. I will rise.
Yes, in Jesus' name, it's yours. Name I come alive to be your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your Spirit, it's yours. It's yours right now. You've been obedient. It's yours in Jesus' name. Resurrecting me. In your name I come alive. It is finished. It is finished. Just receive it all the way, all the way, all the way. There's things going on that you don't even know about, and the enemy is going to try to steal, kill, and destroy, but your God's going to show you what to do in times to come. Oh, not only for you, but for your children.
Soldiers watched in vain.
And Jesus
was borrowed for 3 days. His body there.
Your heart is right.
Our God is robbed
of grace. Our God is robbed of grace. Ooh, la 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 la, God's been doing a work. He did an overhaul. And now it's time to receive. You will be honored and respected in your husband's family. That's the whole family. Thank you, Father. It is finished. In my calm alive. God has not forgotten you, not in a long shot. Take whatever you want for your family, for your job, for your body, for your finances, for your healing, for your son. In Jesus' name.
Resurrecting me.
All fear is gone. You are more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. Abba, Abba, purite hi la 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 fio, purite hi rio, purite. Abba, purite hi rio, purite hi rio, purite. Abba, purite hi rio. We need that once more, Mark. We need that once more. Just dance in his presence. Right now, God has loosed. See, it's him through me. It's not me. Receive. Receive whatever you, whatever he spoke over you. And some of you, God's going to show you what you have need of, and you're going to know it. He's going to reveal things that the enemy is coming up against you, and you're going to take back what the devil's told in every area of your life. It belongs to you. We're going way back to the Garden of Eden.
Once was crowned with.
Thank you, Jesus.
Is crowned with glory now. The Savior knelt to wash our feet. Now at his feet we bow. The one who wore our sin.
It's done. Everything you've stood for, you've been obedient. It's done. You've got your heart's desire now.
The radiance of perfect love now shines for all.
It belongs to you. It's finished. Just take it by faith.
Your name is victory.
So handsome.
He still needs healing on his body.
All praise will rise.
I agree. In the name of Jesus, by his stripes, by Jesus' stripes, he has been healed. He's healed. In Jesus' name. It is finished. It is finished. It is finished. You have been a faithful servant of his. It is finished. Your body is healed from this day forward. No candida. No fungus in your body. It's driven out through the word of God in Jesus.
By your spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By
What you could ever imagine. You have got heart's desires. He is fulfilling those today for your children, for your job, in your marriage, in your home, in every area of your life, in Jesus' name.
Resurrecting me, in your name I come alive, to declare your victory. The resurrecting King is resurrecting me.
You are sold out to Jesus. Your siblings will look to you, and they will be saved. Oh, when he comes in, he comes in like a flood. Just think, when you praise and worship, what happened was there was a flood going through your body and washing out every evil thing. And whatever you have asked, whatever you've been in agreement with God for or with another, it's come to pass. You receive it and you speak it now every day of your life. And you thank God that you are free. You thank God for this word of God. And you speak it and it's going to come to pass faster than you've ever seen before. People are going to say, where have you been? You're going to say, I've been at a service. And God was there and the Holy Spirit did the anointing and took over in the name of Jesus. Do you receive it? Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. You want that song again?
Yes.
Let's do it once more. If anybody wants to leave, they can leave. But just give us that once more. Because God just wants to go. You know what he does? He goes through and he flows through people. And what is he? He's getting the drither and the dross out of us. He's setting us free from everything. You know, and the ideas you once had at one time, he's changed it. Give it to me. Give it to me.
Is crowned with glory now. The Savior knelt to wash our feet. Now at his feet we bow. The one who wore our sin and shame, now robed in majesty. The radiance of perfect love now shines for all to see.
Your name, come here. We don't want to lay hands on you, Father God, for your complete restoration and healing. It is done. The devil has come at you too long. But you have not given up in the name of Jesus. Do you receive that?
The fear that held us now gives way to him who is our peace. His final breath upon the cross is now alive in me. Your name
is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
Your name is victory. All praise will rise.
You are blessed beyond words. I bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Victory, the resurrected King.
I took you, Jesus says, into the Holy of Holies. You will dream about this. You will walk in this all the days of your life. You have tasted the glory. Don't let it go.
Amen.
Oh, thank you, Father.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Amen.
Yes, yes. Jesus washed the disciples' feet.
Yeah.
He had to do that. Do we wash each other's feet? No. No. He washed the sin away. He washed the sin away. We don't wash other people's feet. Jesus is the only one that can wash the sin away. We can't wash it away. But he washed it away.
Amen.
So wherever you go, wherever your feet go, it belongs to you.
Amen.
It belongs. Decree it and declare it now in the name of Jesus. Do you agree?
Amen.
Now I plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of you. In the precious name of Jesus, say, I am wise.
I am wise.
I am smart.
I am smart.
I only listen.
I only listen.
To the good shepherd.
To the good shepherd.
I will not listen.
I will not listen.
To the voice of a stranger.
To the voice of a stranger.
I take by faith.
I take by faith.
Every promise.
Every promise.
That's in this word of God.
That's in this word of God.
This day forward.
This day forward.
I will never be the same again.
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 My family will never be the same again.
My family will never be the same again.
My workplace will never be the same again.
My workplace will never be the same again.
Oh, my prosperity is growing.
Oh, my prosperity is growing.
My healing is finished.
My healing is finished.
For me and my house,
for me and my house,
we definitely serve the Lord.
We definitely serve the Lord.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And they all said,
Amen.
Amen. Watch for things to happen. You know, they said, stretch out your neck like the man was looking for the prodigal son. He was looking.